And mind you, when you're using any equipment, you should make sure that you always return the covers to it. In case somebody accidentally knocks off, if these chances of regaining whatever has was supposed to be spilled is staying intact. Now, we're done with the chlorophyll. Now, formalin. Formalin is a preservative. There are different types of preservative. Now, preserving agents, you can use formalin, you can use salt as a drying agent and as a preserving agent. You can also use alcohol as a preserving agent. But for formalin now, since we have it, we use it to prevent decay. It slows down decay process. And some of these chemicals are used as preservative agents. Sometimes for even food stuffs, usually they are used in dairy products like milk, even in the beef industry. You know, when they can their beef, they will actually use preserving agents of different kinds, but some of them are hazardous too in large quantities if you come if you get to consume them. Now, after I've done this, now we already seen that this specimen is doesn't look alike, right? And for whatever it might be, I see for ourselves that it's no more alike. Now, usually, in snakes, we added knowledge. If you want to hold a reptile, you try as much as possible to hold the head region. You understand? In case, if you hold it like this, it cannot wiggle its head and bite you in another way, as it turns its head around and bite. Now, we have this specimen. Without it struggling, we were able to have it dead and intact. You understand? Now, we have put it inside this container, and then we use it for specimen purposes. Now, the next thing we are going to use is our formaldehyde. You understand? Now, in your, for those who are going to science, human science or medicine, you'll come in contact with more of formalin or formaldehyde. Now, formaldehyde is a mixture of formalin and water. Usually, the formalin can take 70% content, while the water will be 40% content. So that is why it comes formaldehyde. We have our specimen. It's still looking fresh because putrefaction has not taken place. Now, putrefaction is like decay. Understand? Decay of living organism parts. Now, it's still in its fresh state and it's still looking very vivid. When I mean vivid, I mean it's looking very real because it has not taken much time. Now, what you do is that you place it horizontal, and pour your formalin. Depending on the contents of formaldehyde you want. You understand? But mostly they say that you all preferably should make it 75% or 70% submerged inside the container. You understand? Because you see, as it is like this, it is just at an up level, right? And some parts are still out. It's total submersion, not partial. Now, even though it is initially floating, with time it will take its initial position, and then color also will change over time. That is why you see some preserved specimens don't look like the way they actually are after a very long time, but it's still reserving the the internal or the main component for study. As this is here now, we can use this for as long as this jar is closed. Now, after that, the next thing we do is to cover the specimen. Now, after covering this specimen like this, what is the last thing to do? Now, before storage, you have to leave it. That is what differentiates you from other lay professions. As scientists, anything you do, you have to give identification to it and why it is so. Now, I leave S. Now, I now have this, you can see, pasted this, what do I do? I have my pen, what next? Label it, right?
Yes.
Now, because what differentiates you from other professionals is that you are very specific. Because you're going to use this for study, you don't just write lay names of what people might just understand. And this is this. There are some specific guidelines you need to follow. And so that anybody that sees this, you know that, okay, this is this, and you know what it's used for. Now, I will label this as specimen C. Specimen what? Now, for your practical biology, now if you ask the question on specimen C, identify specimen C with reasons, you know what to do. Is that also? You have thought about classification, right? And without no stress, you are finished in preserving specimen C. Any questions? Any questions?
Formaldehyde.
Yes. Yes. No, I did not add the water additionally because I just picked it. That is how it's supposed to be. If you add water to it, but make sure that the ratio of water and the formalin is higher because water dilutes. Is that also? Yes. So, any more questions, please? Now, you notice that after I finished most of the things that I'm doing, I'm taking safety measures. You see that, right? Now, after using anything in the lab, do not eat, do not play, do not touch anything that is unlabeled, and you do not know what it is for. And after that, any questions? Well, you're talking about chloroform. Yes, chloroform is volatile, and if you open it to evaporate, you notice that by the time I opened it, it diffused. Is that also diffusion movement of molecules from region of what?
I understand.
If I had left it open down and applied that sitting close to me, he inhales it. The next thing you know, wow. So that's it for chloroform. Any questions, please? It seems simple, go. Yes. Now, by adventure, I'm not here for 100 years. If I don't tamper with this, it will remain like this. Now, in your excursion that went to human anatomy department, you saw different stages of development. You saw fetus from 0 to 2 weeks, 4 weeks, 6 weeks. The gestation period of which they were writing it down. Gestation period is developmental stages period of the fetus till delivery. And what they used to store it for formaldehyde. Now, do we have any questions? Any question? No question, it seems easy. Okay, now one of you is going to do for this spider. Who is that? What I just did. I want to be wrong. Okay? It's not difficult, right? It's very simple. So,